Welcome to Developing with DocuSign. My name is Aaron Jackson Wild, and I'm a member of the Developer Center team. This video is a continuation of our multi-part instructional series on how to migrate your application to OAuth 2.0. In this video, I'll walk you through how to tell if you are using non-OAuth 2 authentication and how to set up one of the recommended OAuth 2.0 flows, specifically JWT authentication using the DocuSign eSignature PHP SDK. Migrating to use OAuth 2.0 has the following benefits. You'll remove the potential impact of not complying with privacy laws and policies, as well as the legal liability of data loss if someone hacks your app. You'll eliminate the possibility of your app breaking when users change their login credentials. When you implement OAuth 2.0 authentication, you'll be able to manage your app through single sign-on. Because we've deprecated legacy authentication, we no longer document it. When you move to OAuth, you'll be able to take advantage of our documentation, including how-to guides, best practice guidelines, and troubleshooting. Now, let's take a look at what legacy authentication looks like in a PHP project and how to set up your integration to use OAuth 2.0 instead. If your app uses the X DocuSign authentication or WS-security username token header, it is using legacy authentication and it must be updated to use OAuth 2.0. Legacy authentication requires DocuSign credentials, including account email, password, and an integration key. That information is passed as the value of the X DocuSign authentication header. Now, I'll recreate this code using the OAuth methods provided by the DocuSign eSignature PHP SDK. But first, I'll need to gather some information from my apps and keys page. To set up JWT authentication, I'll need to set my app's integration key, RSA key, redirect URI, and an impersonated user GUID. I can find these OAuth elements on the apps and keys page. Under my account information, I can find my user ID, which all uses my impersonated user GUID. Next, to my app name, I can find my integration key. To add an RSA private key and redirect URI, I'll select the Actions button, then choose Edit. Under Authentication, Service Integrations, RSA Key Pairs, I'll select Generate RSA. Make sure to save your RSA private key in a secure location, as it will not be accessible after closing this window. Then, under Additional Settings, Redirect URIs, I'll select Add URI to add a redirect URI for my app. Here, I'll set up the variables to store my integration key, redirect URI, and impersonated user GUID. I've pasted my RSA private key into a file named private key and set a variable to point to that file's location. I've also defined a variable to store the scopes I'll need for my API calls. Scopes represent the OAuth permissions that are being requested. For eSignature REST API methods, use the signature scope. If the access token will be used for other DocuSign APIs, additional scopes may be required. Expires in defines how long the token will be valid for. Once it's expired, I'll need to generate a new access token. The PHP SDK defines expiry in minutes and has been set to 60 minutes here. I'll also need to set a base path for the authentication service. This path differs depending on whether your app is in the development environment or in production. I'll use account-d.docusign.com. Since this is the first time I'm authenticating my app with this specific set of scopes, I'll need to grant permission for the app to perform actions under those scopes. To get this consent, construct a URI value matching the syntax shown that includes the authentication base path, your integration key, scopes, redirect URI, and a response type value of code. For JWT, be sure to include the impersonation scope in your consent URL. In the command line, I run my code script. I paste the consent URL in my browser and log in, see the consent window, and click accept. The response will navigate to the redirect URI. Now that I've granted consent, I can obtain the access token from the API client request JWT user token method. Now I'm ready to start making API calls. I can create the API client as before, but this time I will add a default header with the authorization as the key and the bearer access token as the value. The rest of my code can remain intact. Now, I can run this simple code example which successfully lists the envelopes in my developer account that have had status changes in the last 30 days. You can use this same token to make API calls while the token is valid. You do not need to get a new token for every API call. That's it. Thanks for tuning in. If you have any questions about how to develop your integration with DocuSign, here are some resources. I recommend checking out the following links for more details: OAuth 2.0 requirements and migration, how to get an access token with JWT grant authentication, and recommended OAuth 2.0 flows. If you're watching from our YouTube channel, please post questions and comments below the video or email us at developers@docusign.com.